Chancellor Merkel. Talking to me earlier today. Thank you, Mayor Wolverine. Please, most of all, thanks to all of you. Although tonight I speak to you not as a candidate for president, but as a citizen.
Yeah.
A proud citizen of the United States and a fellow citizen of the world.
Übersetzt
ihr
jetzt
nicht?
Nein.
Oh, nein.
Ich ersetze
noch nicht. Like the spoke. You might be here! The journey here is a problem. My mother was born in the heartland of America. But my father grew up herding goats in Kenya. His father. My grandfather was a cook, a domestic servant to the British. At the height of the Cold War, my father decided, like so many others in the forgotten corners of the world, that his journey, his dream, required the freedom and opportunity promised by the West. And so he wrote letter after letter to universities all across America until somebody, somewhere, answered his prayer for a better life. That is why I am here. And you are here because you too know that yearning. This city, of all cities, knows the dream of freedom. And you know that the only reason we stand here tonight is because men and women from both of our nations came together and struggled and sacrificed for that better life. Ours is a partnership that truly began 60 years ago this summer, on the day when the first American plane touched down at 7 o'clock.
Yeah.
On that day, continent still lay in ruin. The rubble of the city had yet to be built into a wall. The Soviet shadow swept across Eastern Europe. While in the West, America, Britain, and France took their stock of their loss and pondered how the world might be remade. This is where the two sides met. And on the 24th of June, 1948, the communists chose to blockade the western part of the city. They cut off food and supplies to more than 2 million Germans in an effort to extinguish the last flame of freedom in Berlin. The size of our forces was no match for the larger Soviet army. And yet retreat would have allowed communism to march across Europe. Where the last war had ended, another world war could have easily begun. And all that stood in the way was Berlin. And that's when the airlift began. When the largest and most unlikely rescue in the history brought food and hope to the people of the city. The odds were stacked against success. The winter, a heavy fog filled the sky above. Many planes were forced to turn back without dropping off immediate supplies. The streets where we stand were filled with hungry families who had no comfort from the cold. But in the darkest hours, the people of Berlin kept the flame of hope burning. The people of Berlin were proud.
Amen.
Ich bin ein unheimlicher Schauer.
There is only one possibility, he said, for us to stand together, united, until this battle is won. The people of Berlin have spoken. We have done our duty, he said, and we will keep on doing our duty. People of the world, now do your duty. People of